Hi, I'm Paul Barry. Welcome to Media Bites. Or should that be media raids?
A raid by the Australian Federal Police is underway at the ABC offices in Sydney.
So, what's this bully boy tactic all about? Shutting down a free press. The raid centred on a two-year-old story by Dan Oakes and Sam Clark.
Tonight, we reveal serious allegations that Australian soldiers may have committed unlawful killings during Australia's longest war, and claims that the death of an unarmed Afghan civilian was covered up.
Serious stuff, and absolutely in the public interest. But clearly the government doesn't think so, as the AFP hunts down the source of the story to prosecute him, and maybe the journalists as well.
To have a warrant executed on the headquarters of the national public broadcaster in this way, I can't state it enough, is an unwelcome development. It is really serious.
The AFP raid saw the police comb through a whopping 9,000 items, and it came one day after the AFP raided the home of a Newscorp journalist over a separate story. So ask yourself, is this the new Australia, where the government targets journalists over stories it doesn't like? You bet it is. And you should be alarmed. But now to Nine News and this update.
And US President Donald Trump has touched down in England.
Oh no, is Peter okay?
In England.
Don't worry, Peter's not dying on air, just the tape having a heart attack. You didn't think those evening news updates were live, did you? And speaking of Trump, what about this Sky promo in the UK? Yes, the Trump blimp was back, and so were the protesters.
Thousands gathered to protest the American president's presence.
But the Donald saw nothing but love.
I heard that there were protests. I said, where are the protests? I don't see any protests.
Yep, if you say it enough, it's true.
So a lot of it is fake news, I hate to say. It was tremendous spirit and love. There was great love.
Well, there was love from Piers Morgan on Good Morning Britain, who scored a presidential interview and told the protesters they were shameful.
A little bit disrespectful to be waving baby balloons all around the place
just
at the President of the United States.
It's just a balloon. Because,
but what about the war, asked Piers.
Because when we needed the Americans in World War II, they were there for us.
Yes.
And if our response to that country
is to exercise our democratic right
if our response
protest...
And on they went. Breakfast TV with light. But finally, to my namesake in New Zealand. Hilary Barry of TVNZ is no relation, but she does have a good left jab when dealing with complaints.
A subject line that says Hilary's cleavage, that's from Barbara. It says, we are being assailed by more and more of Hilary in low-cut tops, exposing her cleavage.
Really? Tell us more.
It is a fact of nature that women's breasts are sex objects and should be kept private except at the beach or at an evening do.
How quaint. And Hillary's response?
Well, here's the thing, Barbara. I'm just a middle-aged mother of two who slapped on some lippy and a pretty top to look presentable for the nation. And I'm sorry that you find my boobs offensive.
So, did Hillary cover up? Of course not. Hashtag newscleave. As Hillary told Barbara...
They're just boobs. They're just boobs.
And we'll be showing off plenty more on ABC Media Watch on Monday night and also on iView and Facebook. Don't miss it. 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 Don't miss it.